Last time we saw that limits at infinity had to do with horizontal asymptotes. Whenever you have a limit as x goes to infinity of a function being L, you get a horizontal asymptote at x equals L. But what does the limit as x approaches infinity mean? Well, we've talked about this in another learning module. The limit as x approaches infinity of f of x is talking about what happens when x gets bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. You know, think what would happen if you plugged in x equals a 1,000, or x equals a million, or x equals a billion. Imagine plugging in bigger and bigger and bigger numbers and seeing what f of x is getting closer to. That's what we mean by the limit as x approaches infinity. If we say that the limit as x approaches infinity of f of x is 3, it means whenever x is very big, f of x is close to 3. Same thing for the limit as x goes to minus infinity. Instead of looking at 1,000 and a million and a billion, you look at minus 1,000, minus a million, minus a billion. Big negative numbers. Okay. Now, how do we actually compute these limits at infinity? Typically, the most common situation where you find them is when you look at ratios. A typical problem will have a ratio of f of x and g of x, and you find yourself saying, you know, when x goes to infinity, f of x gets very big, and so does g of x. And what can happen when you divide two big numbers? Well, that depends on which one's bigger. So the idea is we want to factor out the things that are big. So for example, if you have the function x squared plus 1 over x squared minus 1, that's getting big as x goes to infinity, and so is that. So we say the limit of x squared plus 1 over x squared minus 1 is the limit of 1 plus 1 over x squared times x squared over 1 minus 1 over x squared times x squared. See, they both blow up like x squared, so we factor out an x squared from both of them. And that's the limit of 1 plus 1 over x squared over 1 minus 1 over x squared. And that's easy, because when x gets very, very big, this is close to 1. This is close to 1. The ratio is close to 1. And so the limit is 1. Another example is we have this. Here, the term that grows the fastest is x cubed. So we're going to factor out an x cubed from the top, and we'll also factor out an x cubed from the bottom. So this is the limit of 5 plus 17 over x minus 15 over x squared plus 4 over x cubed all times x cubed, divided by 8 minus 12 over x, plus 19 over x squared, plus 25 over x cubed, times x cubed. And then we cancel the x cubes. Now, you notice the 17 over x goes to 0. The 15 over x squared goes to 0. The 4 over x cubed goes to 0. All of these terms really don't matter. It's this that's driving the train. All of these terms don't matter, because once you divide by x cubed, they go to 0. So all you're left with is the coefficient of x cubed here divided by the coefficient of x cubed here, 5/8. Now, you might have different numbers of powers at the top and the bottom. So here you have two powers of x upstairs and only one power of x downstairs. When that happens, all you can do is factor out an x squared. So that's the limit of 5 plus 3 over x squared times x squared. And when we factor out an x squared downstairs, you get 2x plus 1 minus 1 over x plus 1 over x squared times x squared. You cancel the x squareds, and now what happens? The top gets closer and closer to 5, but the bottom is still growing. If you imagine plugging in a gigantic number for x, you get something close to 5 divided by a gigantic number. And that gives you a tiny number. The limit is 0. Last example. We saw that when taking other kinds of limits, the square root trick was useful. If you're dealing with two square roots, you can often multiply and divide by the sum of the square roots. And root a minus root b times root a plus root b just turns into a minus b. That's often easier to handle. So if you're left with something that looks like a difference of two terms, what you can often do is this trick. And that becomes the limit of x plus 1 minus x over root x plus 1 plus root x. And that's the limit of 1 over root x plus 1 plus root x. This doesn't grow. This does. In the long run, you have 1 over a gigantic number. And that gives you 0.